to Fabric for the 22nd birthday party there. Bit of an odd one to go to, but I guess if you're Fabric and you're a super club, you have to basically celebrate every day, every year that you're basically, that marks the calendar year when you actually launch or when you opened, right? It just makes sense. But usually people do like round, like, you know, what would you say? Big numbers, right? Like the, like in five increments. So it's like 5, 10, that's what people usually do. But again, if you want to cause a bit of hype and you want to keep it going, then you're going to do every year. So it is what it is. So yeah, went to 22nd birthday. Was lucky enough to get a guest list spot. So again, big up the Connect for the guest list spots. I really, really appreciate that. Not something that I ever expect to be given in all actuality, as somebody has who kind of committed himself to a life of nightlife, a life of nightlife escapades and dancing and other sort of, you know, activities that will not be mentioned in this podcast. I don't necessarily care about guest list stuff. Never really have, to be fair. Usually when you go to parties and raves, if you want to get behind the DJ booth and look cool, you can figure it out on a day. It's not that hard, right? You just need to, you know, talk to the right people, get pally, befriend, smooch, offer a couple keys to somebody, offer a couple bumps to somebody, and suddenly here you are in the DJ booth. So it's not that difficult. But it is nice sometimes if you know you're going out anyway. And then you have the possibility of going out to another place, and then that place also happens to be a place that, you know, charges a pretty hefty price in terms of tickets when it comes to Fabric. It's nice to know that you can go there and just be able to walk in free, and then obviously have the ability to obviously make up that money in terms of drinks, right? That's always the thing. Because someone like myself, I go out, you know, I have a good time. I'm not really tight in terms of spending. So if I get a free ticket, I'm definitely going to be able to use that money just to buy more drinks at the bar. Just adds to my drink, you know, my drink budget. So that was brilliant. Awesome. And again, from all the slander that I've said about Fabric over the years, I have to kind of really swallow it and kind of take a bit of a step back in terms of what they do as an operation. Don't get me wrong. It's not perfect. There are things I don't like about the place. Clearly, I think people have kind of pointed those things out. But in terms of the scale that they run at, the amount of people that come through those doors, the amount of artists they book inside that place, for them to run on a quite consistent basis, smooth nights, get people in and out of that place with ease, have, again, cloakroom issues. I had someone in night get sorted really, really quickly. Loads of logistical little admin things that you don't really think about until you're obviously going through the situation. You just have to clap. You have to really give them a lot of props. Like, they run a very, very tight operation. And everybody, again, who I kind of had to deal with in terms of the entry, ticketing kind of things, was bare safe. That even the security have improved over the years. Security before were flipping horrible. They've improved to some extent. It's just, you know, it takes a bit getting used to when you're used to going to kind of warehouse raves and places in Berlin and other kind of, you know, a bit undergroundy type clubs, to get used to being in a space where there's a million security guards with flashlights walking around the dance floor all the time, checking, making sure you're not getting up to any sort of nonsense. But once you get into the mood and once you get into the flow, you kind of forget about it. But it does take a bit of getting used to. It's just a standard thing of London, really. It's not really something that's only kind of specific to them. Oh, let me get my camera into focus. I think it's not in focus. Is it in focus? There you go. It's not really specific only to Fabric, but it is something you kind of have to think about when you do go to these kind of places. But wow, man. Wow, what a great night. Again, so easy to get in, easy to come out, no problem with that one. Obviously, I went, I went to go see my hero and somebody that I've always kind of looked up to in terms of DJs, you know, him. I'd say Ricardo Villalobos is the person, of course, I'm mentioning, DJ Harvey. And I'd say, as just as somebody to look up to in terms of my approach to DJing and stuff, I'll say those two. Let's keep it just those two. I would say third. This is a weird one to say, but I'd say Seth Truxler, just because of how he came into the game so young. You know, his ability to kind of traverse different scenes. Obviously, now he's kind of firmly in the tech house, sort of stuff, but he came through different sort of beats, I thought, a bit of minimal, a bit of deep. Obviously, now he's heading more so in the tech house space, but I still think he has scope as an artist to kind of get a little bit avant-garde, get a little bit weird, and go in the in a way that people don't really expect. But in general, just in terms of being a maverick in front of the decks and being a little bit of a rock star, being a little bit, you know, unconventional, you know, not wearing totally all black, as you can see in the picture here of Ricardo Villalobos wearing his kind of signature own neck sort of t-shirts, just loungy and, you know, whatever, maybe twiddling his little arms around. But I think Ricardo's definitely always been up there for me in terms of people that I've kind of looked up to in DJ wise and obviously he's a very enigmatic figure, very complex, media shy and just generally a little bit of aloof. And his sets usually kind of reflect his personality, especially when you kind of go on the certain meme pages and stuff about, you know, him being sweaty and maybe being drugged up behind the decks and whatnot. But I think that all adds to his character, that all adds to his allure. And I've always kind of been a fan of seeing him at Fabric. I've seen him, I think, a couple of times there beforehand. But I wanted to see him, of course, in this sort of zone, in this sort of phase of my kind of raving life, where I'm a little bit more in tune with the nights, right? I'm not just going in there in a flipping blur of drugs and alcohol. I'm actually going in there to listen to music, hear someone play. And that was a pleasure to hear him play back to back with Craig Richards. There were moments in his set where he was clanging all over the place, right? But that was, again, it's the charm of Ricardo. It's more so the selection. It's similar to like a DJ Harvey. You don't go to DJ Harvey to listen to him mix, like, you know, seamlessly like you would a Dixon or something, right? You go there to hear him basically, or to hear him. He's not going to juggle three decks like a Devious One, right? But you go there to hear selection, to hear the way he kind of, you know, curates the room, the way he kind of shapes the room, twos and fros, all that kind of stuff. And you saw that with Ricardo. I think I had a couple of chats with people on the dance floor too. They said the same thing. That like, guy's clanging and shit, but I don't care. This is fucking amazing, right? Hearing this sort of music play in this sort of system, you know, tracks that are running like 15 minutes long and shit, like mad, absolutely mad situation. So I loved it, loved every minute of it. Pick up the guy too, taking pictures. Spoke to him briefly as I was standing on the side here, trying to record a sneaky video of Ricardo DJing. Couldn't really get much of it anyway, to be honest, because it's absolutely dark as hell in there. It's not really great for recording, I have to be completely fair, which is a good sign for them. But the guy that took the pictures here, the pictures look absolutely incredible, gotta be honest. Let's read the caption actually with Ricardo. The caption says, 22 years on the Charter, Charterhouse Street. A few days have passed since the euphoric closing moments of our birthday. We've had time to reflect and appreciate what a truly glorious time it was, and also how lucky we are to be dancing with you still after all these years. We wouldn't have got this far without you all. Huge thank you all to everyone who took part of the weekend and to everyone that has passed through our doors in the past 22 years. Old friends, new friends, global friends, they're all on the dance floor. You showed us the magic that unfolds when our literary community come together. Thank you to all the artists too, every single one of them. Put outside the performances, good vibes continuously, start from finish, for your energy, your support, your love. Thank you always to 22 more Fabric. And yeah, wish them 22 more. Honestly, they definitely deserve it, man. They absolutely smashed it. Like, it was a great night, great curation. I missed quite a few good DJs on the Saturday day, on the Sunday day, and obviously the whole of Saturday. But, you know, I was working, I didn't really have time to go. So as soon as I finished, I was able to kind of pop over and see Ricardo play. And I was, again, infatuated with the whole thing. It was just incredible. I actually walked in first and I went upstairs to room 3 to go and see Cormac play an incredibly good disco set. Stayed for about an hour there dancing my absolute face off with absolutely sublime set. So again, big up Cormac. He was absolutely bossing room 3. Didn't even know there was a room 3 actually until I got in there. That's again dummy me. I think maybe that might be a new space, not too sure, because I only usually traverse between 1 and 2. Bump into a couple of good lads as well, people that maybe will be in Berlin at the same time I'm around, so that was nice. And just generally a good vibe. The only thing that was a bit of a shit stain on it was, of course, my tendency to lose things. And secondly, I went to the green room, and I have to be honest, right? A green room in a club, which I've been to a couple, but not a lot, because I don't really, you know, tend to care about those kind of things, getting behind DJ booths and stuff. I've never understood that. Again, maybe because I'm a club kid and I DJ myself, I never really got the allure of people standing behind the decks and like acting cool. I always think that's a bit lame. And I never also got the allure of just being a punter and wanting to go to a green room. I never really got the point of it. Again, like I said, I would much rather be able to get a guest list to go into a rave and just dance my face off and drink loads than, you know, want to beg to get somebody to get me in a green room. I don't really understand it. But let's just say the green room of any nightclub that you would imagine in your head is exactly how it is, but it's even worse than what you'd imagine. I walk into the green room of Fabric and the people in there were, I don't think I've experienced a more colder reception or welcome into a room ever in my entire life. It's my raving experience life. They were, and again, I will just describe myself as quite a extroverted person, right? I try to make people comfortable when I'm around. I try my best to make people like me, right? I have that kind of weird tick as well. I want people to like me and stuff. And I instantly felt like a vibe of like, what the fuck is this guy doing here? Who the hell is this? Like, the eyes were just mad, innit? The only people that were lovely were actually a guy that was showing me around. I wish I remember his name. It was like a Baz Shiraz, something along those kind of lines. That guy was an absolute gent. Whoever that dude was, I forgot his name. He was helping me to find some stuff, and a few of the other guys I met in the back of the green room. But I had to get out there quickly. You know what I mean, I couldn't stay there any longer because those guys were an absolute. Oh, that vibe was terrible. And again, there is something weird about somebody that would want to go to a nightclub and sit in a green room. I understand maybe going in there when the DJ's there so you can shoot the shit. I don't know, talk. I don't know. You know, fanboy or fangirl out, get a couple of quick selfies. I don't know. But going to a party and just wanting to go into a green room is really bizarre. Unless you just want to go there just to do drugs or something of that kind of ilk. I understand. Cool. Do your thing. But if you just want to go just to stand in there, because again, the fabric green room isn't near any of the flipping decks or anything. It's right in the middle of the flipping two rooms, I think, for the most part. So you don't really hear much of the music. It kind of takes away from experience. And again, with their sound system, with how dark it is, and the way things reverberate around those rooms, you want to be in right in front of the decks, like how I was for the majority of that night. Whether it was in room two, room one, or room three, I was right in front of those decks. So that was great. But again, that's a story for another day. But big up everybody there included. I had a great time, enjoyed it. I can't say any bad words about it. Let's quickly scan through the pictures. You got a picture of Ricardo. I'm not sure who that is. That's Seth Troxler. A picture of the crowd. You got a picture here. I don't know who that is getting the spud. You got Cormac, of course, who I saw play in room three. He was absolutely sensational. Again, big up Cormac. Like, great disco set. Like, but disco, I think there was a little bit of Italo, if I'm not mistaken. If I'm not getting too, if I wasn't too high, then I'm sure there was some Italian disco being played there too. Absolutely marvelous set. I met a couple people, a couple of girls at the front. Had an absolute barnstorming night dancing with them, having a little boogie, sharing a couple high fives and spuds. And again, that's the one thing I would say about raving now. Even though I still think the attendances in parties is way down than what it was pre-pandemic, right? I think a lot of it has to do with, like I mentioned in the previous podcast, even though we like to kind of turn up our nose at them, I think the lack of Italian, Spanish, and French, and maybe somewhat German tourists, and maybe even, you know, people from the Holland, Netherlands, people maybe from Scandinavia, that kind of part of Europe, with the lack of those tourists coming over, and maybe them staying home and being more home based or going back home if they were living here. I think it's definitely affected club space and attendances, you know, negatively here in London. But the flip side is that when people do go out, they are so on having a good time. Like, I don't think I've ever, again, apart from the green room, that was an absolute vibe killer. But again, those people that sit in the green room in a nightclub are a different breed of people. Everyone I've met on a dance floor in any club I've been to, again, I've been to a few this, you know, post lockdown, you know, in terms of scale. I've been to 200 places. I've been to 500 capacity. I've been to 1,000. I've been to all these kind of good places where you can kind of gauge what's going on. I don't think I've been to a single party where the vibe hasn't been good. Maybe my vibe hasn't been good going in, but I've not been in the place where their vibe itself on the dance floor has not been good. Everyone's really up for it. So I think this is maybe, if you, again, if you're on the fence about Fabric and you've heard about the bad reputation like I have over the years, this is maybe the best time to go to a place like Fabric. Like, legitimately, like, this is the best time to go. Like, this is such a fun place. It really is such a fun place to go. Everyone's having a good time. And again, I love it because it's a bit more of a, it's not weird to say this, but it's a bit more of a mature crowd, let's say. So you're not kind of combating with a group of 19-year-olds, you know, on their first ketmish, which can always be a bit weird. So that's always quite nice. But I also do like sometimes when they have those kind of younger nights that there is that kind of split, right? There is that kind of difference. There is that kind of mood. And because they've got the chairs, people can sit down, have a laugh, listen to music, and just keep it moving, man. It's all such a great vibe. I'm not going to lie. Don't know who that is. Who's this singing on the mic? That's Josh Kef. Just Cafe, another shot of people in room three again. That room three is pretty banging, isn't it? It's so, you know what room three reminds me of? It reminds me of a little bit of like Plastic People. I don't know if you guys remember this legendary club in Shoreditch on Curtain Road. Legendary club. I think it might have been like 200 people, 150 people max that fit in there. And it was an absolute sweat box. And you're right back up, you're right like bang in front of the DJ. And they have like a little perspex glass thing that sort of went that way back into the DJ, sort of covered them, but you were right back up into them. Sometimes someone played vinyl, you know, the heat would basically warp the flipping vinyl or make this needle skip, and you bumping next to it will make it skip as well. So it just added to the old texture of the night. It was absolutely nuts. It kind of reminds me a little bit of Plastic People, that vibe. Obviously, it's got higher ceilings and stuff, so it's not as kind of intimate and dark, but it's still a great use of space, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, that's Rudhad again playing, I think, in room two. Does that look like? That's room two at the top of the balcony bit. That room two, how that spectacle, especially when you look at it from the front in, from the back all the way through, is just banging. It looks like a cathedral of techno and pain. And yeah, obviously, the real Craig Richards here playing as well. Earlier, I think maybe this was what back to back with Ricardo. Again, he held the fort. Big up Craig Richards. Whenever Ricardo would clang the hell out of the place, Craig Richards would come in and just kind of save the night. I mean, he was the glue that held that set together. But again, I think they go off each other. They work off each other really well. They've been playing together for many, many years, so I'm sure they know how to, like, pick up on their energies and go here, go there, whatever it may be. So yeah, big up everyone involved in Fabric. I think honestly, legitimately a decent night. But 20, anniversary parties are a bit weird in general to go to. Sometimes they can attract a weird crowd, but I thought this was one of the better ones I've been to. And again, it's kind of made me reappreciate and maybe fall back in love with Fabric in general as a venue. Again, that's the room two with Cormac that was in. So again, I appreciate those guys for doing that in that respect. And just, yeah, just a great night, man. I really enjoyed it. And again, pick up Ricardo, an absolute legend. I'm excited to see him again. I really want to see Ricardo Hustle or DJ Harvey. DJ Harvey, who I'm a fanatic about. Seen him play, many places, followed him around the country and shit. But I remember once seeing him play at Berghain, right? So I specifically went to Berghain to go see him play, and he was listed that he was going to play Berghain. That's how mad it was. It wasn't even he was listed to play in Panorama Bar, which makes more sense because that's the more housey sort of kind of place, right? Housey disco thing. And he absolutely tore Berghain a new one. Like, he tore it a new one. And it was fantastic to see a DJ who you kind of think in your head is more alternative disco, whatever, Paradise Garage, whatever that sound is, right? That kind of, it can go anywhere from like prog rock to like new wave to indie dance to new disco, whatever, right? But you wouldn't think he would be Berghain material, right? You wouldn't think that would be his place that he would also play, but he did, and he absolutely killed it. And I would love to see Ricardo playing something similar, whether even it's not a burger, if it's like a fold, or he's playing at like an Ismus, or he's playing at like a Herand, however you pronounce it, Herand, or it's like a Sinoid, one of those really classic techno parties, and he just plays there. I would just love to see. I really would. I don't think he would play that sort of stuff, but it'd be great to see regardless. But yeah, big up everybody, loved it. Fabric was a vibe, 22 year anniversary, and like the caption said, hoping for 22 more years from these men. Let's get the camera focused. Cool.